like wireless and mobile communication. Wireless, as the word says, without wires. Currently, everybody is using mobile phone, laptops, and these devices provide the facility of Bluetooth. Who invented Bluetooth? From the word, the first thing comes in mind is, might be the person with beauty. No, it's not like that. I'm just kidding. It was started as a project by a Eastern company in 1994 and named after the king of Denmark, Harald Blaatand. So, we are going to see the overview of Bluetooth. What is the overview of Bluetooth? So, it cuts the cord and establishes the connection. As we all know that Bluetooth is just a wireless communication. It doesn't need any cords for the transfer of files or data. It transfers data through low power radio waves whose frequency ranges from 2.4 GHz to 2.485 GHz. It is divided into three classes. The first class is industry application, range 100 meters. Second is mobile phone, Bluetooth headset, and its range is 10 meters. And third, it is very rarely used, and its range is 1 meter only. Through Bluetooth, we can connect one device to seven devices and form a network called a Piconet. Yeah. Through Bluetooth, we can connect seven devices. From one device, we can connect seven devices. And the network formed, by the communication, by the connection of these devices, are known as Piconet. Now, how file is transferred? In Bluetooth, how file is transferred from one device to another device? Bluetooth uses ISM frequency band for communicating with other devices. ISM, what is ISM? Industrial, scientific, and medical device. Every Bluetooth device is transmitting under receiving end. The file is transferred by the spectrum frequency hopping technique. The technique which is used for the transfer of file is known as spectrum frequency hopping technique. That is, parts of file is sent by small bursts of radio waves whose frequency can change up to 1600 times per second to avoid interference in the problem domain. Okay, now moving ahead. The new smart Bluetooth technology uses 0.1 to 0.5 volt. Hence, using Bluetooth doesn't drain our phone battery quickly. It uses a very low power, so our phone battery long lasts. It was developed by Asian company, as I have already told you that it was a project. Project by Ericsson company, and initially called as short link radio technology until 1997 when it got the name Bluetooth. Now, what is Bluetooth? Bluetooth originally started by Ericsson company, as I already told you, it is a wireless LAN technology to connect devices of different functions, like they have already discussed that it is wireless LAN technology. It is an ad hoc network, which means the network formed is continuously. What is ad hoc, we will see in further level, slides. So the devices sometimes are called gadgets, find each other and make a network called a Piconet. What is Piconet? So architecture of Bluetooth. What is the architecture of Bluetooth? It defines two types of networks, Piconet and Scatternet. So what is Piconet? A Bluetooth network is called a Piconet or small network. It can have up to 8 stations, one of which is primary, the rest are called secondary. All the secondary stations signalize their clocks and hopping signals with the primary. It can only have one primary station. Communication between the primary and the second station can be 1-to-1 and 1-to-many. A Piconet can have a maximum 7 boundaries. 7 boundaries and additional 8 boundaries can be in the part of home state. This is a diagram of Piconet. This is a primary station, and the remaining stations is known as secondary stations. Now, scatternet. When two Piconets are combined or joined, then that network is known as scatternet. Now, see that Piconet can combine to form what is called scatternet. A secondary station is one Piconet can be the primary in another Piconet. A secondary station means, we have discussed that Piconet, scatternet is combination of Piconet. When is the Piconet, the primary, the secondary station of one Piconet, can be the primary for another Pconet. This station can receive messages from the primary in the first Pconet as a secondary and empty as primary deliver them to secondaries in the second Pconet. Station can be member of two Pconet. See that there is a primary station, all the other secondary stations are connected, and another Pconet is combined with this Pconet, and the secondary station of first Pconet is behaving like the primary station for another Pconet. Now let's see the architecture of routing. Just see the layer from the bottom: radio, baseband link controller, link manager protocol, logic link controller, and adoption protocol. That is connected to the RF communication. RF communication is connected to OX, WAP, and the logic link controller and adoption protocol is connected to the STP and TCS. Now we will see this one by one. First of all, we will see the major features of Bluetooth. What is the major feature of Bluetooth? A, cable replacement. We have already discussed that it is a wireless connection. It doesn't need any cables for the communication purpose. Now, second point is ad hoc network. What do we mean by ad hoc network? So by ad hoc network, we mean that every network can create its own network and another device can join the network. Now, what is access point? So what is access point actually is internet of one device can be used by another device. That is the meaning of access point. So radio layer, very specification. What does it do actually? What it does? It do. The three main features are frequency handling, modulation, air interfaces. Air interfaces means it has to see the nearby environment. Now what is baseband link controller? As we turn on the button, it searches the nearby device. We all use Bluetooth in our daily life. As we search, as we switch on our Bluetooth, it searches the nearby available devices and shows in your device, nearby you. If any device is connected to Bluetooth device, its timing will be in baseband. Any device is connected, the timing is shown in baseband connection. So connection management is also checked here. So it is the feature of baseband link controller. Link manager protocol. Suppose someone is creating Bluetooth connection and one friend is also joining the connection, so Bluetooth connection is established between us until after the work is not done. We have to manage the link between Bluetooth devices. This work is done by link manager protocol. Encryption standard, authentication, security protocol. Logic link protocol and adoption protocol, L2TAP. Now see the diagram. The software and hardware. The above part is connected by the below part. This is logic link control and adoption protocol. This we can see that it is a connection, it is a link to connect the two parts, whatever have the parts. Now, service discovery protocol. Suppose we have established the connection, the other device that is not reaching, the other to connect or not. HTTP handles how the information is shared to other device, like the service to provide, call to provide, Verma, internet, a file transfer. Now, what is RF communication? Verification communication. What is RF communication? Whenever we transfer file wirelessly or using internet, this all come under RF communication. TCS, telephone controller specification. What is the telephone controller specification? It works on bit-oriented protocol. Now question arises: what is bit-oriented protocol? Now it is just speech establishment between two users. When we are using for calling function to Bluetooth, then it is controlled by the process bit-oriented protocol. Hence we use calling Bluetooth all process done in bit-oriented protocol. OX is object exchange. it is none other than HAL transfer. HAL transfer is just objects. BAP. What is BAP? BAP is internet. When we use internet through Bluetooth, that is BAP. Wireless application protocol. Thank you for watching this video.